Hello, my lovely Aries. This is Aish Rose, also known as Healing with Aish. And this is for anyone that has Aries in their sun, their moon, their rising, or even in their north node. So welcome, happy new year. I haven't seen you guys in a while, but this is just for you guys. Let's see how you guys are. I have already pre-shuffled. I hope that you guys are okay. How are my lovely Aries doing? I feel like you guys are ready for something new. You're in this new year, new me energy. And I like it. It's nice. Some of you guys may not have... you may be isolating yourself a little bit right now. So, for instance, you may not be going out with your friends as much. You may have taken a bit of time out. You might be doing dry January. Some of you guys just taking some time out. You're not really partying, not really going out. I mean, it is cold. And a lot of Aries, I know you don't like the cold. It's too cold. Okay. Okay, I got the Six of Pentacles in the reverse. For some of you guys, you could feel like in your friendship groups, there's not a lot of equal give and take. You could feel like... You could just feel like, why am I here? Like, why am I here? Like, if I don't make money, it don't make sense. Or, you know, it's just, I'm just getting this energy of, I don't really want to waste my time. Like, it's just not equal give and take. Like, I'm just not really getting anything out of being outside all the time, partying all the time. I'm not getting anything out of it. I like it. I feel like you're just in this new energy. Yeah. New energy. Hear this song. I feel like you're in this new energy and you're just like, I'm just ready for something new. Okay, so for some of you guys, you could be in a partnership with possibly a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, or that you find this person, they could be a little bit older than you. They could be quite wise. You could find them very intelligent. Others of you guys, you could be dealing with a Leo, but I feel like you're really looking after yourself right now here, yeah? I've got the Judgment card, also could be a Libra for some people, but I feel like you're calling judgment on your life. A lot of people are at this time. This is nice. You could have Leo placements in your chart as well. But I feel like right now you're listening to your higher self. You could be tapping in more into your spirituality. You could be connecting more with the divine, keeping up with your prayers. And really trying to connect to just be a better you. I feel like there's a lot of better you, better me energy, right? I really like that. I feel like you're trying to be wise here. I feel like you want this year to be different. This year to be different. I feel like you've learned a lot of lessons in 2020. Thank you. Wheel of Fortune. The wheel is turning in your favor. Okay, I feel like you're like, I've learned a lot. The strength. I feel like you've overcome a lot as well. As I said, you could definitely have Leo in your chart somewhere. But I feel like you're very strong, Aries. I feel like you've been through a lot. And I feel like people underestimate how strong you really are, but you show them every single time. So they can underestimate you all you like, especially when it comes to these friends or whatever this might be. I feel like it takes a lot of strength to turn around and say to people, you know what, this isn't serving me anymore. I don't want to do this anymore. And it takes a lot of strength and a lot of courage. You guys are very strong here. I love this, Aries. Yeah, you're very strong-willed. And I feel like your strength is one of your greatest qualities within you. I did have the King of Pentacles in the reverse. So some of you guys could be feeling like you either want a new job or you would like to increase your finances. You could just be having a little bit of worries about your finances or your stability at this time. And that could be something that you really are trying to work on in 2024, which is a good thing. The Ace of Cups has come out. So your heart chakra is open. As I said, you could be in a new relationship for some people. The Empress, be careful of fertility. You're very fertile at this time. some of you guys could be expecting, or if I'm speaking to a masculine, you could have somebody that's expecting, or you wouldn't mind starting a family with this person. Some of you guys could be manifesting pregnancy for some people. Others of you guys, you are in a brand new situation, or you're manifesting love for yourself, which is really nice. Whoever this person is that you could be connecting to, if this is a masculine, this person does have a lot of love for you here, yeah? A lot of love for you, which is really nice. Stay in that energy, that loving energy, Aries. It's nice. I love this for you. Queen of Pentacles and upright, which is good. So if I'm speaking to a masculine, you could be dealing possibly with an earth sign, a Capricorn, Virgo, or a Taurus, or Libra. I've also got Leo. But you could find that this person's very stable. This person could be quite good with their finances. So you could feel like, you know, I want to match that energy. This person might work quite a lot, might work very hard. Yeah, Eight of Cups in the reverse. Tell me something about this Eight of Cups in the reverse. Queen of Swords. I feel cold. I feel cold now. So, separate note, take this how it resonates for you. But there could definitely be somebody here. This could be a mother figure for some people. This person could be a Capricorn, Virgo, or a Taurus. But this is definitely mama bear energy. Or this could be like the mother of your child. You take it how it resonates, an aunt. Somebody that is older than you, possibly. But there could be quite a lot of emotional baggage with this person. You could find this person can be quite cold at times. Or just sharp with their words here. But I feel like you're trying to use your judgment when it comes to this person. Tell me more. Some of you guys, you could have a kid with this person. Or as I said, this could be like a mother figure. I feel like when it comes to the situation with whoever this person is, you could kind of feel a bit bored. Like, things are always just the same. Like, things are just not really changing with this person when it comes to, like, their attitude. And there could have been a time where this person really had you conflicted within your mind, yeah? Always playing mind games. But I feel like you see through the BS. You see through the bullshit here, yeah? Ace of Swords, I feel like you just want the truth. And if this person, you could feel like this person doesn't really tell the truth a lot. But you could just feel like, you know what? I'm going within, yeah? As I said, I feel like a lot of you guys are keeping up with your prayers right now, or you're really into meditation, listening to your higher self and making sure that you're putting your best foot forward, which I love. I feel like with you, you just want the truth with this person. Like, you can feel like this, you're just tired of this person just always being selfish, I guess. Four of Pentacles, yeah? You could find that this person's quite selfish. There could be another energy here too. I've got the Queen of Wands, Sagittarius energy, Aries energy, Leo energy. There could be two females here. The Star. I feel like you've lost hope in this connection with whoever this person is. This, you take out, resonates. It could be a mother-daughter dynamic, or it could be like your babe mom and her mom and friends. You take out, resonates though. But whoever this Queen of Wands is, this Queen of Wands is younger than this Queen of Pentacles. Let me show you. She's younger. So you take out a resonance. Could be like your mom, your sister, whoever this is. You take out a resonance. But I feel like you've lost quite a lot of hope when it comes to kind of like expecting. I feel like before you kind of expected more from these people. But I feel like you've got to a stage where you're just like, you see things for how they really are. You see the truth in the matter, and you're just like, some people just don't want to change. And there's nothing really you can do about that. You just have to keep focusing on yourself and keep focusing on your happiness, yeah? Make sure that you're thriving, and that no matter what, you keep moving forward, okay? Because you've got a lot of good things coming towards you this year, Aries. So don't let this stuff distract you, okay? Set boundaries. Six of swords, right? Moving away from things that no longer serve you into calmer waters here, right? Because I feel like there was a lot of deceit here, Seven of Swords, a lot of things that were said behind your back, a lot of gossip. But no matter what, keep moving forward, yeah? Misery likes company, and hurt people hurt people. Hurt people hurt people. So just keep focusing on bettering yourself, because the energy that you're in is absolutely beautiful. And never forget how strong and beautiful you are, okay? Just because they want to undermine you doesn't mean that it's true. They need to focus on what they've got going on, and you focus on you. Because you've got a lot of good things coming for you this year, Aries. And don't forget that. Keep your heart chakra open. Make sure you're praying over your situation with whoever this new person could be. Oh, it's a lot of hate. It's a lot of hate. My candle just went crazy. There's a lot of hate, a lot of hate.
Yeah, you see the background?
Let me
change the song.
Sheesh. It's a lot of hate, man. Why? Because there's something new. God's giving you something beautiful. Ace of Pentacles. This is a gift from the divine. It's a lot of hate. Just know that. Don't worry about it. Don't focus on it. But just know that. Don't, you know, be careful of telling people your plans, your next movements. Keep certain things to yourself, especially if you're in a new connection. Keep that to yourself. Protect your relationship. That's what I was going to say before I had to blow the candle out, was pray over your relationship, yeah? Pray over yourself. Pray over your union, yeah? Okay. It's a lot of hate. It's a lot of hate, a lot of hate, a lot of hate. Yeah. I feel like a lot of you guys could be taking time out right now. Could be resting. You could be kind of sleepy these days. But that's okay. It's just your body's... let your body heal, especially if there was like not emotional abuse, but maybe like a trauma from whoever these people are. Give yourself grace to heal and know that you're human, you know, and just rest. If you feel like you need to rest, take time out. This is the perfect time to rest. It's January, not much is going on. Take that time out for yourself. Some of you guys could be a little bit ill with the flu or cold or whatever this could be for you. But just take some time out to look after yourself, mend yourself. See how she's got that heart there. And it's like on a ribbon. Mend that heart of yours. Keep that heart chakra open, right? You're sitting here as the Empress, especially if I'm speaking to a female. Even if I'm speaking to a masculine, you are very in tune with your feminine energy right now, which is good, which means you're very in tune with your emotions right now, which is very healthy. Okay. Something new is going to be brought into you, so make sure from the divine. This could be a new job, this could be new income. It'll be different for everybody, but something new is coming in. So make sure you stay in this positive mindset. Stay positive, okay? And protect your blessings. Keep moving forward no matter what. Some of you guys could be dealing with a cancer for some. Thank you. Yeah, because there's someone in the background here that could be doing some magic here. Magician in the reverse. Or just manifesting illusions. So to keep you in an illusion. If someone from your past, you either grew up with this person or... you've known them for a long time, or you have kids with this person, take it, it resonates. But there are people here, I feel like it's more than one person. It could be at least 6 to 7 people. So this could be some family members, some old friends. But like they want to keep you, yeah, Seven of Wands. It's like, especially when it comes to like your career and things like that. Keep you stuck, so you don't really know what you should be doing, where you should be going. But whenever you don't know what you need to do, just, you know, call on the divine, call on your angels to guide you, because they will guide you here. And if you feel like you need to take time out to just think and meditate, do it. Make sure that you have clarity before you move straight into something. If you don't know what to do about something, just pray on it. Yeah, because you could be balancing right now, especially when it comes to your finances. Just pray on it and give it time. okay? This is a marathon, it's not a race. Yeah, try and avoid the quick rich schemes, those types of things. And just start investing in yourself, because the happier you are, the more you'll be able to manifest abundance for yourself, okay? But this is looking really good. As long as you stay in this energy and don't let other people project onto you, you're good. You're good to go. As I said, something new is coming in, especially when it comes to your finances. So keep your head up, Aries. I love this for you. You deserve this. You really do. You really do. Yeah. Some of you guys could feel like, you know, Nine of Cups in the reverse. You could feel like, you know, your blessings aren't coming in, or you just can't see them yet, but they're coming. They're on their way. They're manifesting. The song in the background is Another Dollar. It's coming. I'm telling you, it's coming. Whether this is a new opportunity in work, whether this is a promotion, this is something, though. Someone also could just, you know, they could end up giving you money, whatever this is, but just keep working on yourself. Keep putting out that good energy. It will come in for you. It will come in. As I said, some of you guys could be out of work, or there could have been issues at work. But as I said, something new is coming in. Stay in that high vibe and energy, and don't let anyone project this confusion, illusion onto you. Make sure you keep yourself protected. If you know certain energies, when you're around certain people, it don't make sense. You feel at ease. You feel anxious when you're around certain people. Don't ignore your intuition. It's okay to take time out and say, you know what? Me and you lot, we don't really make sense. We're not cut from the same cloth, and that's okay. Sometimes you need to put boundaries. Sometimes you need to protect your peace, and don't ever be afraid to do that. Don't ever feel bad for doing that. You have to look after yourself, okay? And I feel like that's exactly what you guys are doing. The wheel is turning in your favor, okay? You deserve this. You deserve this. You deserve to be happy, Aries. Tell me something more for my lovely Aries, please. Mature man. Okay, what about this mature man? And for some of you guys, it could be a male figure that's doing this. Yeah, that could be in despair. Got despair that's come up. Who is this mature man that's in despair? This could be a father figure for some of you. Poverty. There could be somebody here, and possibly a father figure, that could be in poverty or has a poverty, you know, mind frame. But somebody could have lost a job here. You could, whoever this person is, you could feel like this person doesn't even think of you anyway here. Yeah, doesn't even think of you that, like, they may not reach out or may not speak to you as much as you would like. Tell me something about this main female. This person could also have a partner, like a younger partner. If you take that how it resonates for you. But you may not trust this person, yeah? Journey. Some of you guys may be taking a trip as well to see this person. So for some of you guys, this could be like a father figure, grandfather, your dad, take it how it resonates, uncle. But somebody here, you could be wanting to take a trip to see this person here. This person may not be telling you how bad things possibly are right now with them, but yeah, in the distant horizon, I feel like you will get news about this. You will hear something, not for you to worry about, but I feel like in the distant horizon, you may be planning a trip to go see someone soon. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, courthouse. Some of you guys may have recently been in court. Some of you guys are going to be getting engaged. I could see courtship here, a privileged lady. Could be some of you guys are also going to receive like an inheritance, like a land, a house, something like that, right? For some of you guys, not for everyone, but for someone here, yeah. Yes, if it's an inheritance, or like it's, you're marrying into, like your person may have, you know, maybe well off, or there's something here about papers though. So this could be like, you know, either for some it's like a divorce settlement, or you're going to receive land or something along those lines, or you own land, or there's something that's going to come in for you guys in the distant horizon. So make sure you're protecting your blessings here, okay? Let's see, get some angel card messages. Archangel Michael, can we please get some messages for my lovely Aries? Can we please get some messages for my lovely Aries? Oh my gosh, sorry if you can hear screaming in the back. Please, can you get some messages for my lovely Aries? You guys could be having fun at this time. Make sure you're doing things that make you happy, yeah? Watching comedy movies, comedy shows, spending time with people that you love, doing things that make you feel good, cooking a nice meal, dressing up, working out, whatever that might be for yourself. Make sure you're doing all of that. Put all of that love and happiness back into yourself. Can we get another card for them, please? Lovely. So the first card that came out is, no, it's not time yet. I feel like this has got in relation, this is something to do with court or like papers or something like that. But it says, this is not the divine time to take action. Please be patient. The opportune moment is approaching. Okay, so as I said, take some time out to rest. Look after yourself. Put that energy back into yourself because the divine is going to bless you with something. But don't take action right now, okay? Apparently, you take it, it resonates. The next one we have is, welcome abundance into your life. And it just says, prosperity is on its way to you. Have faith that source will heal your financial challenges. Lovely. As I said, God is going to bless you with something, whether you believe in source, the universe, Allah, God, whatever that might be for you. But you are going to be blessed with something here, especially when it comes to financially. Okay, so this is forever for... different areas, this will come in different ways. This could be from a court settlement. Some of you guys is a new job. You take out resonates, but something is going to pick up when it comes to your finances. So take the time out now to heal, set boundaries with people, and put all that love and energy back into yourself so that you're ready for this abundance. Whatever you've prayed for is coming in, but now you need to pray for being able to sustain it for when it comes. Okay? I love you guys. Take care of yourself, and I'll see you soon. Bye.